It's time to stop creating dashboards in the Grafana UI. They can't be version controlled, can't be integrated into CI/CD pipelines, and can't be created dynamically based on different data sources. Instead, you should create dashboards in code using Jsonnet. Let me show you how. Jsonnet is a data templating language created by Google that is a superset of JSON, so it can be compiled to JSON or YAML. It supports functions, variables, imports, loops, conditionals, and even has a standard library. To get started, you can either install the C++ implementation of Jsonnet or install the Go version, which is orders of magnitude faster in some use cases. Then install the Jsonnet bundler, which is used as a package manager. And if you're using VS Code, you can also install the language server. After you've done that, you're ready to start writing some Jsonnet. Create a file with the Jsonnet extension, and then you can add some code. You can create variables and functions using local. You can use Python's style list comprehensions, and in this case, it's creating an array of ages, which is summed and divided by the length using some methods from the standard library. The last value of the expression in Jsonnet is automatically returned, so no need for a return keyword. If we scroll down, you'll notice that both the dollar sign and the self keyword is used. Self refers to anything inside this object, and the dollar sign refers to anything top level. We'll open our terminal and run the following command, which will produce this JSON file. How cool is that? Let's do something a bit more interesting. Here, I have Grafana running locally, getting data from Prometheus, which is scraping data from my host machine using the node exporter. If you want to know exactly how I did this, then take a look at this video, link in the description. Anyway, all Grafana dashboards can be exported as JSON, and you can also import dashboards as JSON, which means dashboards can be created using Jsonnet. And to make things easier, Grafana have created a library called Grafonnet to help you make dashboards in Jsonnet. Let's go ahead and install it. We'll first need to run JB init to prepare our project for dependencies. Then we can run this command to install Grafonnet. Once that's done, it will create a vendor directory, a Jsonnet lock JSON file, and it will add dependencies to our Jsonnet file. Let's import Grafonnet under the variable Grafana. We'll create some variables to reduce the amount of code we write, and then we'll create our dashboard with a description and a time threshold. Now these methods here return JSON objects, and the plus symbol here is a way for Jsonnet to merge these objects together to make a single object. Next, we'll add a panel, which will be a time series graph with the name CPU usage. We'll give it a query target, which will contain the ID for our Grafana source and this PromQL. We'll give our panel a width and a height value, and also change the unit. Now, because I want to add a few different targets, what I'm going to do is create a function which takes the CPU mode as an argument, adds it to the PromQL, and uses it to create a legend. We'll replace this code with our new function, and then add a Prometheus variable. And that's it. But before we run this code, we need to add a JPath flag to our vendor directory so that Jsonnet knows to look in there to find dependencies. And now we have this JSON code. Let's go ahead and put it into Grafana to see what dashboard it produces. So after using the import option and pasting the JSON, I've created this dashboard which shows CPU usage. Let's add another visual. But before we do that, I mean, let's face it, self-hosting Grafana to create visuals is great. But if you want a hosted option with many more features, then you should check out BetterStack. With BetterStack, you can connect metrics from Prometheus and create really nice dashboards with a drag and drop interface. But that's not all. You can also create status pages, manage incidents, create alerts, and much, much more. So go and check out BetterStack right now. And we're back, adding a second visual to our dashboard. We'll make another time series graph called memory usage, which again will have some targets. The first one being the total RAM, and the second will be the used RAM. We'll then add a width and height value and also change the unit. Now you can already see that we're getting some repeated code. This is a good opportunity to turn some of this code into libraries that we can import using Jsonnet. By convention, we create a lib directory and add a file with the libsonnet extension. Although custom libraries will still work with the Jsonnet extension, libsonnet is the preferred approach. We can now add the code for our panels, and Jsonnet will only expose these two functions. We can now update our main file to import our panels, which makes the file much cleaner. Of course, before we run this, we need to add the lib directory to the JPath flag, and after we run it, we get this JSON file. Let's put this JSON into Grafana, which will give us this dashboard showing both the CPU usage and the memory usage. Now, just through this example alone, you can already see how powerful Grafonnet is. Imagine if you had tens or hundreds of different dashboards and you wanted to update the alert thresholds based on some new SLOs. Doing that manually using the UI could take a long time, but doing it programmatically using Jsonnet would be very quick. Don't get me wrong, the Grafana UI is great for prototyping and making simple dashboards, but Jsonnet with Grafonnet is perfect for managing dashboards at scale. If you want to see more of what Grafonnet can do, then check out the API documentation. If you're a Kubernetes user, then check out Grafana Tanker, which helps you make Kubernetes manifest files using Jsonnet. And finally, if you enjoyed this and want more of this content, then be sure to subscribe.